Hey guys, Becky here with Design Bundles, and I'm super glad to have you join me today because we have another amazing Cricut Design Space tutorial. Today we are talking about how to make knockout designs.
Okay guys, so here we are in Cricut Design Space, and this is just a blank canvas, nothing special about it. The first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and start off by typing out some text. So I'm going to click my text box over here. I'm going to type out heart, and then I'm going to create another one that says breaker. Now from here, I am able to select these individually, and we are going to go ahead and select our font. Now the font that I'm using today is called the Lioness. It's a font that I scored from Design Bundles, or rather Font Bundles, and I really like it a lot. Now, the reason that I selected this font is for a knockout font design like this, you need a blocky text. You need a text that is going to situate really closely together, and it's going to be a nice, thick, bold font. Okay, so it doesn't necessarily have to be blocky, but blocky is what comes to mind when I'm choosing designs of this nature. Now, the first thing that I want to do is I want to go ahead and change my letter spacing. I want to reduce it so these letters are nice and cozy. Probably right there, 0.2 will be good. And then I want to move them closer together so that they're also close in their line spacing. You may be asking, why did I type these out as two separate text groups? That is because I want to make them the same width. So I see that here. The word breaker is 4.87 inches wide. So I'm going to copy that and I'm going to click on heart, unlock the aspect ratio, and paste in that measurement. So that way they're the same width exactly. Now I'm going to select both of these, use my align tool, and align center horizontally just to make sure that they are even on each side. And then I'm going to use the weld to weld those together. Now, that is how we're going to set up the font portion. The next part that we need is a shape. I'm just going to use a shape straight from the shapes available on Cricut Design Space. And I'm going to do something similar. You can see if I select Heartbreaker that my shape is 4.648 inches tall. Now, you don't have to copy and paste these like I'm doing. I am going to leave the aspect ratio locked on that one. But if you don't want to mess with a copy and paste, you can type those in manually. And then I'm going to select both the font and the heart. I'm going to use the align to align center. So we're going to select both of these. We're going to use our slice. And what I like to do is I like to choose my options from over here on the right-hand side. So I want to delete out this portion here. Because what I want to do is I want to keep my letters. And then I want to delete one set of heart letters. So that leaves me with the outline letters with the heart subtracted out. And then it leaves me with the inside letters that are in the shape of the heart. So now I can select my corresponding colors. I can make these any colors that I want them to be. But just to get a visual, I'm just going to select two different color reds. Now you'll notice that it has the thick black line. That is not actually going to be part of your design. If you want to get a true representation of what it'll look like, switch it from no fill to print, and that'll get rid of that black line for you. Now you will switch that back before you cut, but for the most part, that is completely done. Now when you switch over to make it, you'll see that whatever size you have it, it's going to break it up into your two respective colors. And then what you'll do with whatever ultimate project you're making with this, if it's vinyl, you'll just turn around and layer it. It'll fit together just like a little puzzle piece, and it's just really, really super awesome and easy to make. So I said we were going to do one more project, so let's move this one off to the side. So I'm going to start by typing out my text again. This one will say super star. So let's go ahead and make these a little bigger. And we already know that we can reduce our letter spacing to 0.2, because that's what we found out in the last project. Bring these a little closer together in their line spacing. All right, super is 4.341. I'm going to copy that. Come to star, release my locking for the aspect ratio, and paste in the width. Select both of these, align center horizontally, weld those together so that they're now one piece. Let's go ahead and grab a star from Cricut Design Space. Now, Superstar is 6.09 inches high. Now, this time I left the lock aspect ratio even. And I want you to notice that my star and my words, my star is actually a little bit wider. So what I'll do with my text is I will unlock the aspect ratio and I can just make it a little wider. Okay, so now I'm going to take that 6.9 and I'm going to use it on my font. Okay, that stayed the same. So now let's select both of these and choose Align Center. And then I can use the slice tool again. So I'm going to take out this outside piece here. That's the outside part of the letters. And I'm going to remove the black portion of the star. So now, again, I can put these in any color that I want. There we go. And if I want a preview without the black line, then I will just switch that to print. So the whole goal, let's talk about this for a minute. The whole goal of a knockout design is to keep your letters fluid. You want to keep the entire shape there. But you're switching up the colors, that way you can make a popping contrast of the shape that fits on the inside. But at the end of the day, the goal is still to be able to read the letters and to read the text. So you want to make sure that you're choosing colors that both complement and stand out. If the colors are too similar, then you won't have a lot of the pop wow factor for you to be able to see the shape that's on the inside. But if you choose some that are too different, then sometimes you won't have a cohesive feeling when you're looking at the letters to be able to read the text. So I really love playing with the colors in Cricut Design Space until I can get it worked out. So for example, I may use the gray and the yellow, but it won't be on a white shirt, but maybe I could use it on a black shirt. And that looks a lot better. Okay, so just something to keep in mind. Make sure that you're choosing the right colors for the project that you're working on. Now remember, if you click over to make it, now this is going to pick up both designs, but you'll see that it splits it out into all the colors that we created. And then I would just be able to cut this out of the corresponding material. Personally, I see knockout designs a lot in regards to making team spirit shirts and sport shirts. They're very popular for high school teams and that sort of thing, or even, any team that you're not going to have to worry about any type of copyright infringement. So just something to keep in mind because that happens a lot with teams. But guys, I promise you this was going to be quick and easy. This is probably one of the easiest tutorials that you can follow along using Cricut and the slice tool. And don't forget that we do have a full video on the ins and outs of using the slice tool. It's very informative and it can show you some really awesome designs in addition to this one that you can make using the slice tool all by yourself. So we're going to go ahead and wrap it up today, guys. But this is our quick and easy knockout designs.
So guys, how did you feel about creating knockout designs in Cricut Design Space? It is by far one of the easiest designing processes that you can do. Using that slice tool is really just amazing. I mean, there's so many different ways that you can interpret it to create the designs that you're looking for. Now, don't forget that we do have that other video on other projects that you can create using your slice tool. So definitely worth checking out, especially if you enjoyed today's video. And speaking of enjoying today's video, if you don't mind, give us a quick like if you learned something today, share with a crafty friend, and guys, I really appreciate if you would subscribe to the channel. That really helps us to support the channel and keep bringing you these really amazing videos. So of course, if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave those below. If there are other things that you want to see in the software, I love to hear those video recommendations from you guys. And you know, I'm going to wrap it up, but guys, I just really appreciate every time you stop by and pay me a visit. And thanks again. So I will see you again next time.